Good evening, students. We are in the chapter of Understanding Quadrilaterals, third chapter. So in the last video, we have completed up to question number 2 from exercise 3.3. Today, we will continue from question number 3. So we are going to do from exercise 3.3, page 51. Let us start from question number 3. So what is question number 3 states for us? Can a quadrilateral ABCD be a parallelogram if angle D plus angle B is equal to 180 degree, AB is equal to DC is equal to 8 cm, AD is equal to 4 cm, BC is 4.4 cm. And angle A is equal to 70 degree and angle C is 65 degree. Okay. So now let us do this. So we have to check a quadrilateral ABCD is given. We have to say whether it will form a parallelogram. They have given three conditions for us. Okay. For each condition we have to check whether this will form a parallelogram or not. Now, if quadrilateral ABCD, I draw any four-sided figure. A, B, C, D. Now, in this quadrilateral, the first subdivision says angle D and angle B gives you 180 degree. Angle D plus angle B is 180 degree. Is it possible for us? In a quadrilateral, we have only angle, the sum of the adjacent angles are 180 degree. So, we write the condition in quadrilateral ABCD. We know sum of adjacent angles are 180 degree. So now, this is not adjacent angle, opposite angle. So it may parallelogram or it may not be a parallelogram. Because if it is a rectangle, 90-90 you will get no. It may be a parallelogram, but not necessary. So we say, therefore, given angle D and angle B are opposite angles. It is not adjacent angle. So, the given quadrilateral may be a parallelogram or not. It may or it may not. Okay. Now, second subdivision. In the second subdivision, they have given AB is equal to DC is equal to 8 cm, AD is 4 cm, BC 4.4 cm. So, when we draw this diagram, no? In this, we try to substitute. AB is equal to DC equal to 8 cm. This is also 8, this is also 8. So, our diagram should be equal. Is it not? AB. If I take this as AB, this as CD, both is 8 cm. A to D, 4 cm. But BC is 4.4. We know in parallelogram, opposite sides are equal and parallel. Here what happens? One pair is not equal. So it cannot be a parallelogram. So, we write, this diagram is for second subdivision. We draw the diagram. So, how we draw the diagram? They have given us AB and DC are 8 cm. What is AB and DC? Opposite sides. So, we write now in the quadrilateral ABCD. AB is equal to DC, this is given 8 cm. Also, AD equal to 4 centimeter, BC is equal to 4.4 centimeter. AB equal to DC 8 centimeter, yes, opposite sides are equal. These two are opposite sides, they are equal. But AD and BC, this is opposite side, but they are not equal. So, for this two, we will write, these opposite sides are not equal. Okay. So, you got it only, one pair is equal sides, another pair of opposite sides are not equal. So, we write, therefore, it cannot be a parallelogram. Okay, because opposite sides, only one pair is equal, other pair is not equal. So, by the third condition, it cannot be a parallelogram. Then the third subdivision. Angle A is 70, angle C is 65. So, when we take the diagram, what we have done? Here, they have given A is 70, angle C is 65. But we know sum of opposite angles in the quadrilateral, what it should be, opposite angles should be equal, no, in parallelogram. Here it is not equal. So, angle A is 70, angle C is 65 degree. Given, angle A and angle C are what? Opposite angles. Angle A and angle C are opposite angles which are not equal. Okay, so what we know in parallelogram, opposite angles are equal. In parallelogram, opposite angles are equal. Therefore, angle A is 70 degree, angle C is 65 degree. Cannot be a parallelogram. Okay, it cannot be a parallelogram because opposite angles are not equal, which is one of the property in parallelogram. So, in this way, we have completed question number 3. Then we do question number 4. Draw a rough figure of quadrilateral that is not parallelogram, but has exactly two opposite angles of equal measure. Okay. So, we know it is not a parallelogram. But at the same time, it should have two opposite angles of equal measure. So, we know by our kite property. Okay. So, in question number 4, we say, we draw a kite. A, B, C, D. So, these opposite angles will be equal in kite. So, we say A, B, C, D is not a parallelogram. Is it not? So, what happens now? Only angle B and angle D are equal such that opposite angles, angle B equal to angle D by kite property. That is a property of the kite. So, in parallelogram, the kite, rectangle, parallelogram and kite when you consider. Here, opposite sides are not parallel, but the angles are equal by kite property. Then, question number 5. The measures of two adjacent angles of the parallelogram are in the ratio 3 is to 2. Find the measure of each of the angles of parallelogram. So, what is given? Parallelogram they have given you. Okay. So, we write question number 5. We draw one parallelogram because the question itself they have given the measure of two adjacent angles of parallelogram. So, when you take A, B, C, D, adjacent angles are in the ratio 3 is to 2. So, what we know by adjacent angle? We know sum of adjacent angles in parallelogram is 180 degree. So now it is in the ratio 3 is to 2. So the ratio 3 is to 2, we can consider it as the ratio 3 is to 2 given. Therefore, let adjacent angles are 3x and 2x. So, what we know by the property of parallelogram, sum of adjacent angle is 180. So, 3x plus 2x is equal to 180. What is 3x plus 2x? 5x is equal to 180. X is equal to 180 divided by 5. 5 will go in 180. 5 3s are 15. Remainder 3, 30, 36. So, we got x is equal to 36. Therefore, what is 3x? Because we have to find in the ratio of 3 is to 2, no, we have to find the angle. 3x is 3 into 36. 3 6 are 18. 3 3s are 9 plus 1, 10. Then we have to find 2x. 2 into 36, 72. To check what we have done correct or wrong, you add and see 108 plus 72 is 180 degree. So, in this way, we have find the adjacent angles of the parallelogram, which are in the ratio 3 is to 2 is 108 by 72. So, that we write it as a statement. So, the measure of, therefore, measure of each angles of parallelogram in the ratio 3 is to 2 are 108 degree and 72 degree. Okay. Now we do question number 6. Two adjacent angles of a parallelogram have equal measure. Find the measure of each angles of parallelogram. So now they have given the diagram itself as a parallelogram. So, let us draw one parallelogram. In question number 6, two adjacent angles of the parallelogram have equal measure. Find the measure of each angles of parallelogram. So, we draw the parallelogram. A, B, C, D. Adjacent angles. If I consider A and B are adjacent angles, they have equal measure. So, I can put it both to be equal. Then we know the sum of adjacent angles, sum of adjacent angles of the parallelogram is 180 degree. We write, we know in parallelogram, sum of adjacent angle is 180 degree. Therefore, x plus x is equal to 180. 2x is equal to 180, x will become 180 by 2, which is 90 degree. So, we have to find measure of each angles of parallelogram. So, x is 90. So, what happens? Therefore, angle A is 90 is also equal to angle C, because you know opposite angles are equal. Same way, when you have angle B, x 90 degree is equal to angle D. So, in such a way, we find measure of each angles of a parallelogram. Next, question number 7. The adjacent figure, hope is a parallelogram. Find the angle measures x, y and z. State the properties you use to find them. Okay. So, we have to, you see the diagram in your textbook, we have a diagram. There is a parallelogram, HOPE. Now, in this parallelogram, we have to find X, Y, Z. So, now, you see, you consider this triangle. in this HOPE, if you consider this triangle, the 70 is exterior angle. You know exterior angle is equal to sum of interior opposite angle. So I can write y plus z equal to 70. So I'm going to write, okay, when you consider like this, in triangle, what is this triangle? You can see in this triangle, in the parallelogram HOPE, I consider only a part of a triangle. In this triangle, I can see this exterior angle 70 degree is equal to y plus z. Exterior angle is equal to sum of interior opposite angle. So, I will write in triangle HOP. Angle y plus z is equal to 70 degree. So, I have written angle y plus angle z is equal to 70 degree because I am going to write the property exterior angle is sum of interior opposite angle. Okay. Next. Now you can see here, next part. What is this angle now? So I can write in HOP, all these three angles put together is 180 degree. So I can write now, this angle HOP, okay, that is what I am writing. Therefore, angle HOP is equal to 180 minus y plus z. This angle, because angle sum property, all the three angles put together 180 degree. So, 180 minus y plus z is HOP. Now, what is y plus z for you? 110, is it not? So, this part will become 110. Angle HOP is equal to 180 minus 70, which is 110. You can use linear pair also, is it not? 180 minus this 2 is linear pair. This is 70, this is 110. When this is 110, what will be the x? X is also 110. Therefore, x is equal to 110 because angle HOP is equal to angle x, opposite angles in parallelogram. Okay, so angle x we got it to be 110. Now we have to find angle y and z. So how we are going to find? Now you see in this diagram these two are parallel lines because it's given parallelogram, no? So for us these two are parallel line. This is transversal. So when this is transversal, this is 40 means y also should be 40. Now this is 40, this is 110. So 40 plus 110, 150. Remainder is 30. So in that way we have found. Therefore angle x is equal to 110 because this is 110 by linear pair. So opposite angles of parallelogram are equal. So we find x is 110. Then we consider the condition PE is parallel to OH and PH is transversal. So angle 40 is equal to angle Y. Y alternate interior angles are equal. So now we write now EP parallel to HO. EP parallel to HO because it is parallelogram. In parallelogram, opposite sides are parallel. Okay. Whatever you write the statement, immediately you should write the condition in the bracket why we are writing. So, when EP and HO are parallel, this HP line, therefore, HP is transversal. HV is transversal means angle 40 is equal to angle Y because these two are alternate angles because you know alternate angles are equal. Angle 40 is equal to angle Y. Alternate angles are equal. So now we find Y 110, Z you should find. Therefore, angle Z. What is angle Z for us? In the previous one, we have done angle Y plus angle Z is equal to 70 degree. Angle Y plus angle Z is 70 degree, sum of interior opposite angle. That also we can use. So, angle Z plus angle Y equal to 70 degree. Angle Z plus 40 equal to 70. Angle Z is equal to 70 minus 40, 30 degree. So, in that way, we have found X is equal to 110, angle Y is 40, angle Z is 30. And this sum is very, very important sum for you. I will mark in your textbook only. The sums will be asked for your exam for 4-mark question. Because here we are using linear pair and we are using opposite angles of parallelogram are equal. Then we use opposite sides are parallel. So, HP is transversal. Alternate angles are equal. So, in this sum, we are using 3-4 conditions to get the solution of the variable X, Y, Z. Very, very important sum. So, please mark it and practice it. Now, in question number 8. In question number 8, first sum, the following figures, guns and runs are parallelogram. Find X and Y. There are two subdivisions are there. They have given G, U, N, S vertices. In this is a parallelogram and they have given some measurement. This is 3Y minus 1, 18, 26, 3X. It's given parallelogram. So what we know? Opposite sides are parallel and equal. So, we use that property and we do the sum. So, we write for the first subdivision of 8th one, opposite sides are equal and parallel in parallelogram. This we know by property. Therefore, can we write 3y minus 1 equal to 26? Therefore, I can write for you, gu is equal to sn. This side, gu is equal to sn. What is gu? 3y minus 1 equal to 26. So, what is 3y? 26 minus 1 get transposed to other side plus 1. So, 3y is equal to 27. Y is equal to 27 by 3, 9. Also, we should find un is equal to gs. Un is equal to gs. What is un? 18 is equal to 3x. 18 is equal to 3x. So, 18 by 3 will become x. So, x is equal to 6. So, we have found the values of x and y. Now, we do second subdivision. In second subdivision, this is a parallelogram. The diagonals part are given. If we consider this as O, O to R is 16, O to N is x plus y. O to U is y plus 7. O to S is 20. So, what we know about diagonals in parallelogram? We know diagonals bisect each other in parallelogram. We write now. Diagonals bisect each other in parallelogram. Therefore, in Diagonal RN, therefore, in diagonal RN, this RN, shall I write OR is equal to ON? OR is equal to ON. What is OR? 16 is equal to X plus Y. Make it as first equation. 16 is equal to X plus Y. Now, when you consider diagonal SU, in diagonal SU, OS is equal to OU. In diagonal SU, OS is equal to OU because it bisect each other. OS is equal to OU. What is OS? 20 is equal to Y plus 7. Therefore, what is Y? Plus 7 will become minus 7. 20 minus 7, 13. This Y is equal to 13. Substitute in 1. So, when you substitute in 1, what is 1? 16 is equal to X plus Y. 16 is equal to X plus 13. So, 16 minus 13 equal to X. This number 13 get transposed to minus 13. So, 16 minus 13 is 3. So, 3 is what value? X value. So, we have found X value and Y value. So, what we are using here the property? For the 8th sum, first subdivision, we use the property. Opposite sides are equal and parallel in parallelogram. In the second subdivision, we use diagonals bisect each other in parallelogram, and we have found the values of X and Y. Okay. So, finding these values of X and Y, these types of sums are all very important because you are using the property and making an framing an equation and finding the values like your linear equation in one variable. Okay. So, today's class we have done up to question number 8. Please practice all the sums. Get clarified if you have any doubts. We'll meet you in the next class from question number 9. Thank you.